Each and every one of us has an unlimited inner wellspring of spiritual power. You have the ability to transform, create, and heal anything upon which you set your heart and mind. Join me, Sarah Hall, as we learn how to uplift all aspects of your life through spiritual empowerment. Enjoy weekly guided meditations, spiritual discussions on a multitude of topics, and a chance to call in to receive channeled messages from the angels on your spiritual journey. I'm Sarah Hall, and this is Through the Eyes of the Angels. Hi, everyone. I'm so grateful to be connecting with you live today here on the Project Bring Me to Life Network, where today's theme is how to care for your spiritual sensitivity. This discussion couldn't be better timed, as I know a lot of you have been feeling extra sensitive to spiritual energy lately. We just had an intense full supermoon this past Monday, and according to NASA, it was the closest the moon has been to the Earth in the past 70 years and won't come that close to the Earth again until November 25th, 2034. Wow. So since the supermoon was very intense, we will continue to feel its effects through most likely the end of the week. And if you're spiritually sensitive, that can mean you might be feeling extra moody or sensitive to emotions, whether they're your emotions or even other people's that you're picking up on. You may be feeling extra sleepy and craving more quiet and rest, or you might be feeling highly intuitive, feeling extra receptive to spiritual impressions, messages from the spirit world, or even having very intense dreams. Part of being spiritually sensitive means that you can feel cosmic events very acutely. You may have a very strong response to lunar events like the full moon we mentioned, astrological events, or even to solar flares. A solar flare is a giant release of magnetic energy from the surface of the sun, and it radiates energy throughout the entire electromagnetic spectrum. Spiritual sensitives, empaths, children, and pets especially seem to feel solar flares and can experience sometimes exhaustion, head or body aches, changes in our brain balance, strong emotions, or just an overall sense of heaviness and energetic pressure. Now, certainly, what affects a sensitive person in actuality affects us all. We're just as aware of those effects to varying degrees, and we might respond differently to them than people that don't maybe identify as being sensitive. So in the example of how we're affected by cosmic events, you can see this as highly evident if you talk to maybe nurses or doctors who see much higher activity in the ER and police officers who see higher crime rates around the full moons or even around solar flares and things like that. So it does affect all of us. Sensitivity is a gift because it feeds those who are sensitive with information and awareness that can help the collective through big changes in consciousness and health and in changes in the environment by learning a little bit more about what's going on. Learning to nurture your spiritual sensitivity is in actuality learning to create a lifestyle and a system of values that can actually help the whole world along. So let's dive in and explore this topic, you guys. This is a topic about which I'm truly passionate, as I think that caring for our sensitivity can create greater overall happiness in the world. Before we dive in, I do want to mention that later on in the show, you will be getting a chance to call in to ask questions. And you can ask about our topic, or you can also ask questions for the angels about your own life, whichever you prefer. The number to call in is 240-979-4111. So go ahead and write that down for later. Again, the number is 240-979-4111. And know that even if you don't get through for a reading today, you can always book an angel reading with me through my website at www.seraphim.com. That's www.serraphim.com. All right. So are you ready to dive in? Let's do it. So I'd like to start first by exploring exactly what is spiritual sensitivity. Spiritual sensitivity is a term I use to describe all forms of psychic sensitivity, or all the ways in which your mind, body, and spirit may be picking up on the subtle, invisible forces around us, such as the mental and emotional energy of others, such as cosmic energy from the sun, moon, and planets, spiritual energy from angels, deceased loved ones, or elemental spirits, or even picking up on memories that have been imprinted into a specific place or an object. If you think you may be spiritually sensitive, then listen closely, because your spiritual sensitivity may actually be a tool that you are meant to use in completing your soul's purpose on earth. If you'd like to be more spiritually sensitive, know that all of us have the capacity to attune our awareness to spiritual energy by setting the intention to do so and embarking on a spiritual path in which we practice honing and connecting to those senses. Spiritual sensitivity is on the rise at this current time in our collective evolution as a species. As we've discussed before on this show, humanity is in the midst of a collective blossoming of consciousness by which we are expanding our ability to sense and understand that we are all one. This process is one that will be continuing throughout our lifetime and will be triggering a lot of changes, some of them beautiful and creative, and others that may potentially be very challenging and call for the breakdown of old system and ways of life that maybe don't serve us anymore. Know that whatever the outer circumstances look like, the changes in this world are part of this movement towards our being more deeply aware of our unity. And these changes give us the opportunity to create a harmonious human world that reflects that unity. Now, through this collective awakening, something is happening to the spiritual energy that moves through each of us as individuals at all levels of our being, mind, body, and spirit. What is happening is that the resonance or vibration of your spiritual energy is shifting to a higher or lighter frequency. You see, everything in this universe is constantly moving and vibrating, changing. Everything has a resonance. Even the non-physical aspects of us, such as our mind and our spirit, everything has a resonance. The faster moving, higher vibrations are associated with higher consciousness and light, a higher and more connected knowledge, understanding, and awareness of the universe as one living entity. Higher consciousness is filled with the power of love and harmony. Lower vibrating consciousness, on the other hand, represents a mindset of perhaps separateness from the whole and a lack of that holistic awareness. Lower consciousness is associated with the ego and some of the more negative or fear-based aspects of our being. You can think of higher consciousness as maybe having more of the bird's eye view of the truth, wherein we can easily and harmoniously navigate through the tides of life. And maybe lower consciousness is having a smaller, narrower view, wherein our focus might just be centered more on personal, self-oriented, or even fear or ego-based concerns. As our species evolves, it is a very important and also a natural part of our progression to move into higher consciousness. And we've been doing this for generations upon generations. And right now is especially exciting a time for that progression because we've arrived at such a pivotal moment in which there are great numbers of people sensing and moving towards that higher consciousness. As we do so over time, we will be able to live in greater harmony with one another and greater harmony and sustainability with the earth, which is much needed. This is our destiny, and you and I are co-creating it now by learning together and working to shine our light in the world together. We're magnifying it. So let's look a little bit more closely now at how that progression of collective spiritual growth works at the level of the individual, at the level where you and I are feeling it happening in our day-to-day experience. Overall, this shift is creating heightened sensitivity in human beings at each level of being. Perhaps you've even been noticing that you're more physically, emotionally, or spiritually sensitive. That sensitivity represents a more active, high-functioning awareness within us, an awareness that is programmed to take us into higher consciousness, a place in which we are acutely aware of what serves us as a harmonious human collective and what does not serve us. Because of that, that sensitivity may create feelings of intolerance to things that simply don't serve that higher good. During this shift in consciousness, you may be noticing subtle differences in your perspective, mood, or awareness. You might notice that your relationships are beginning to change as you become increasingly aware of the way that we share energy with those close to us. You may find that you are able to pick up on the emotions, thoughts, and intentions of the people around you. Your worldview and your sense of life purpose may also be evolving to encompass a desire to make a positive impact. You may find that as you think about world events or the state of the environment, for example, that you can actually feel some of the strong collective feelings that are being held out there in the world by majorities of people. For example, many spiritually sensitive people have felt highly emotional through this past election season in the U.S. as they not only processed their own feelings through it, but also the feelings of other people in the world that they were picking up on. And there was a lot of heaviness that was out there. Still a lot of it that a lot of people are working to heal and shine some light on right now. So make your mark on that by shining your light, doing something positive in this world, something creative. Another hallmark of spiritual sensitivity is that you may feel physically sensitive to harsh, unhealthy environments, substances, or energies since your vibration is moving farther away from these lower resonating things. The physical body is very much involved in this process of shifting. What happens to the spirit happens to the mind and also happens to the body. You cannot affect one aspect of your being without affecting all three. So in terms of this movement into a higher vibration, your physical body is shifting at the DNA and cellular level. The physical body is becoming less and less tolerant to harsh substances or chemicals as it responds more and more sensitively, for example, to their effects. Throughout the past decade or so of my experience as an intuitive healer and a guide, I have repeatedly worked with people who have felt overwhelmed by their growing spiritual sensitivity. They might feel really different from the crowd as their perspectives and their feelings change. Some may find that they have more emotional feelings and responses to the world around them than usual, and perhaps even become more introverted than usual, or even feel physically exhausted or experience some brain fog from processing so much of other people's spiritual energy without properly grounding and then shielding their energy or nurturing their needs as they enter into this new vibration. And it is possible to feel totally sane, centered, and normal with your sensitivity. It's all about just being able to maintain that vibration without letting the things that you're picking up on change the vibration. Something incredibly helpful I have discovered and experimented with is that through proper self-care, you can help your spiritual sensitivity to reach its highest potential, all while feeling balanced, happy and healthy, which is great. So let's begin talking about some of those techniques for self-care. And let's begin with how you can engage in self-care at the level of your spirit. Your spiritual body is made of spiritual light and energy. Your spiritual body is highly responsive to your thoughts and feelings and shifts according to the way that you're feeling or thinking. The spiritual energy body, much like your physical body, has many interconnected flowing parts and layers to it. Perhaps one of the best known parts of the spiritual energy body is the chakra system, for example. Your chakra system is sort of like a system of major organs that represent the greater functioning of the spirit. And they contain memories, they contain emotions, both from this lifetime and those past and so forth. When our chakras and greater spiritual body are clean, clear, balanced, and completely open in their connection to source, we feel connected in our chakras to God, in other words, then we'll feel happy and we'll experience overall health and fulfillment in our lives. So that's definitely what we want, right? So how do we keep our spiritual energy body clean, clear, and balanced? One way is to practice chakra clearing. Chakra clearing is a form of energy work that you can practice on yourself easily, or you can receive chakra clearing from an energy healer. Practicing chakra clearing daily or perhaps weekly, whatever suits you, is usually the best for those who are highly sensitive, as it will keep you feeling light, happy, and balanced regularly. Chakra clearing is wonderful because as you learn to observe your chakras, you'll learn to gain insights as to what's going on at a deeper level for you emotionally, sometimes even physically or energetically in your response to the world. If you'd like to learn an easy way to begin clearing your chakras, you can check out my free guided meditation on YouTube entitled Guided Chakra Clearing Meditation with the Angels. And that's one way that you can just learn how to visualize using your mental focus and your meditative abilities to clear and shift your chakras. Anybody can do this all on their own. Energy work in general is highly beneficial for staying centered and clear as a spiritual sensitive. Receiving and practicing Reiki, for example, is very, very helpful. And what I always say about receiving energy healing is that, yes, it's great to do it on yourself. Everybody is capable of it. Everybody can use their spiritual energy by visualizing where they want it to go, the kinds of changes that they want to experience in their energy. But also receiving it from a healer is another experience that is very, very good for us. The analogy that I use sometimes is that, yeah, everybody could cut their own hair if they wanted to, but sometimes it's easier just to have somebody else do it. Because when you're doing it yourself, then, you know, you don't always have, you're subjective, so you don't always have a view of where all the work needs to be done. Whereas an outside observer, an outside healer might be able to provide you with additional insights that will help even what from your picking up on. So I love to receive energy work myself and highly recommend it for those that I work with. Aside from chakra clearing, there are two other energy healing practices that I consider essential in staying balanced as a spiritual sensitive. And those two practices are cord cutting and grounding. These are so important. Cord cutting is the process by which you release your energetic attachments to unhealthy situations, beliefs, or even relationships. When we are attached to something that is throwing us off balance in life, it will show up in our energy body as a cord through which our energy can be drained, or through which we might even feel like we're receiving toxic energy. One way to know if you have a cord is if you feel overwhelmingly tired, depressed, anxious, or moody, chances are you have a cord attached to you. Cutting the cord is a fast way to release the attachment and to also shift your perspective to greater peace. And yes, you can cut those cords without necessarily visualizing it energetically, by simply healing the issue in your mind or in your heart, or making a strong choice in your life that will take you away from the imbalanced or unhealthy situation. But certainly approaching it from all areas that you can gives you the most powerful chance to overcome whatever imbalance might be going on. And cord cutting is so effective in that. If you want to learn more about cord cutting, you can once again go to my YouTube channel and you can check out my guided meditation for cord cutting there. Now, the last energy technique that I think is essential in helping for spiritual sensitives is grounding. So many empaths and lightworkers feel ungrounded at one point or another in our lives. In other words, you might experience feeling absent, floaty, clumsy, groggy, or feel like you're living maybe in a little bit of a fog. Part of the reason for this is that you're energetically maybe wanting to float up into the stratospheres, dreaming of higher dimensions and reaching out to be home in heaven. This is very normal for many people who are spiritually sensitive. Also for those who can pick up on the energies and vibrations of higher beings, such as the angels, you might really just find yourself always wanting to reach out and be close to the higher beings that are guiding you. Those higher energies are comfortable, attractive, wonderful places. And it's great to connect with them. You should. But it's even more powerful, much better, if you just integrate that higher part of you and your relationship to these higher realms and so forth into your present earthly life, rather than escaping the present and flying away from the body and things like that. Know that you are most powerful and effective when you are fully grounded and have integrated your full presence and awareness in the here and now. Stay grounded, and you will feel less vulnerable also to the energies of other people or intense, busy environments. There are several techniques for staying grounded too. One that I love, this is one of my favorites, is to walk barefoot on the earth for just a few moments. This is really, really helpful because your physical body has its own sort of electromagnetic force field, just like the earth does. And connecting your physical body with the electromagnetic force fields of the earth just does something to reset you. It gets you nice and grounded. So go outside and breathe the fresh air, or hug a tree, and you'll immediately feel a little more present in your physical body and in the present moment. It's so helpful. You can also stay grounded by staying physically active and exercising. Being really, really aware and present and alert in your physical body just naturally keeps you grounded. Or, of course, you can ground yourself through meditative energy work. If you'd like to ground in that way, you can, again, go to my YouTube channel for my free guided meditation I have up on grounding with the fairies. That's a fun one. I like that we ground with the fairies, and that the fairies are good at helping us to ground because they are connected to Earth's energy, and they'll teach you just how to keep your energy connected in the Earth as well. Now, speaking of meditation, let's talk about how to keep the mind balanced and nurtured as a spiritual sensitive. Meditation is perhaps one of the best forms of staying centered, balanced, clear, and healthy as a spiritual sensitive. Meditation will help you to still your mind and release anyone else's thoughts or feelings you may be processing aside from your own as well. Meditation teaches you to discipline both your mind and your spiritual energy so that you can be aware of the spiritual energy around and in you without taking on other people's stuff, other things that are floating around in the world. That, my friends, is one of the core key principles to staying happy and centered as a spiritual sensitive. You can sense and be aware of the energy without personally taking it on or letting it be a burden to you. That's the key. Meditation teaches you to do this. Practicing becoming mentally still and quiet allows you to learn how to observe the flowing river of energy and thoughts in you and out there in the world without needing to dive into the river and let it carry you away. You can just observe this energy as stuff that's moving either through or past you, and selectively choose which energetic information is useful for you in whatever you're working on in your life. The more often you practice meditation, the better. I have found that some of the best times for practicing meditation are early in the morning when you wake up to set the tone for you just before you start your day, or at night just before you fall asleep to help you detach and clear yourself of the day's events to create a clear, clean mind for your sleep time. Sleep is also actually something that's incredibly important for spiritual sensitives too. During our sleep, we do not only receive physical healing, rest, and rejuvenation, but we also receive spiritual healing and rejuvenation. During our sleep, our angels and spirit guides often work with us in the astral realm to help us process our lives, or even to train and teach us on some level or another during our sleep, so that we are maybe out of our body working on spiritual gifts. So many people that I've talked to who feel that they're spiritually sensitive have reported that they've been aware of this on one level or another, that in their sleep, they're working on something, they're out of their body, they're channeling some kind of guidance or healing to the outer world, towards world issues, or maybe even being trained as a light worker. Often when you're in the middle of a big spiritual shift in your personal life, you'll require extra sleep than usual. If you feel the need for extra sleep, my best advice is honor your body and mind and give it exactly what it needs. Regular cycling in your sleep and wake cycles are essential for staying clear, healthy, grounded, and happy as a sensitive. It's such a sacred, beautiful time to connect with the soul, and even again, as I said, to connect with the angels and guides. It's a reset. Another way to keep yourself clear at the level of the mind is to engage in healthy, positive self-talk. You are a piece of God with highly creative abilities, and your mind is the primary canvas upon which you create your reality. Train your thought cycles by choosing positive thoughts based in self-love, and your spiritual resonance will stay high. Emotional healing, maintaining healthy boundaries and channels of communication in your relationships, and making self-love a primary part of your decision-making keeps you clear and healthy at the level of your mind, and thereby, of course, at the level of your spirit and the level of your physical body. It's also important to state that most spiritual sensitives feel highly sensitive to what they see in the media or in entertainment, in movies, television, or the internet. Keeping your mind clear of unnecessarily violent thoughts, images, or information is so helpful for spiritual sensitives because, as I said, it keeps you from going on a vibrational or emotional roller coaster ride. Remember, if you're sensitive, you're most likely in a state that is growing and evolving. You're shifting towards something new. And in that way, there's almost a level of vulnerability or openness that you have as you're shifting. And so the thoughts that you put inside your mind are feeding and becoming a part of that process of growing and changing. If you feed yourself strengthening thoughts and ideas, you will feel strong as a result. Now, the last area of self-nurturing I think is important to discuss in this topic is how to care for your body as a spiritual sensitive. Most spiritually sensitive people respond incredibly well to healthy dietary changes. Many become increasingly sensitive to unhealthy foods and substances that contain unnatural chemicals, preservatives, or pesticides. So eating organic, healthy foods keeps you feeling clear on all levels. Many spiritual sensitives also feel sensitive to eating meat and animal products. Some can sense the spiritual impressions of the animals that they consume and prefer not to partake in that energy, especially if the animal products were produced in a cruel environment. I always tell my clients that it's important to explore dietary changes and to see what will work for you and your level of sensitivity. Some people feel their best with a very pure vegan organic diet. Some feel their best eating animal products that are sustainably and organically sourced. It's important just to tune in to the feedback your body is giving you. If you notice that you have strong mood swings, for example, when you consume, let's say, caffeine, then you might be one of the many spiritual sensitives who cannot tolerate mood-altering chemicals in their diet. Listen to your body and make changes as you feel guided to do so, and this will help you maintain a level of comfort, ease, and happiness with your sensitivity. Physical health and comfort are so key in feeling light, aware, and empowered, so that again, you do not have to ride a roller coaster ride of mood swings or vibrational fluctuations throughout your life. You can remain in a relatively light or high vibration without taking on lower vibrations and letting them change your state if you nurture yourself well. To stay powerful and strong vibrationally, create and practice strength in your physical body and your mental discipline. Remember, what you do to your physical body, you do to your mind and you do to your spirit. So each gesture of strength and health that you make will be highly supportive for you in maintaining long-term stability and remaining rooted in higher consciousness, again, without letting the vibrations you're picking up on in the world take you on a ride to other places. Stay centered. And as you stay centered, as you hold space for remaining in that higher, lighter energy or frequency, you're holding space for the rest of the world to join you in that space as well. And that's most of our mission here. Most of us that are called into connecting with those higher energies are, in a way, being asked to serve by helping other people to come into that lighter, higher, happier, more balanced state as well. So what you do to yourself, you're also doing for other people. Remember, too, that you can also ask for the help from your angels and your spirit guides in shaping and guiding your spiritual sensitivity. Pray and ask for energetic support from heaven, as well as guidance on how to make the healthy changes that you need to live a fulfilled, balanced life as a sensitive. Speaking of prayer, let's all come together now for a group prayer and guided meditation. Yay, this is one of my favorite parts. Today's intention for our guided meditation is to help everyone who's feeling sensitive to come into balance and to receive exactly the support they need in their lives. So let's all get nice and comfortable, close our eyes to visualize our inner world, and take in a few long, deep, healing breaths. As you're breathing, visualize that you are being surrounded now by a group of angels. The angels gather around you, standing shoulder to shoulder in a circle of light. Breathe deeply and allow these beautiful, loving beings to channel that light and healing energy from the palms of their hands and their hearts straight into your heart. Take several deep breaths here, just really allowing yourself to be fed by the love and support of the angels. As you feel the angels' light entering into your heart, allow the light to spread, moving upwards as the light flows up into the head, into the shoulders, down the arms, out the fingertips. Breathing the light into the lungs, allowing it to flow downwards, down through the torso and solar plexus chakra, down to the lower parts of the physical body, moving out your energy's root system as it flows out your spine, feeling the light move through your legs and feet, out your toes. And then with your next deep healing breath, allow that light to sink down right into the earth. Feeling Mother Earth holding you, cradling you in her love, as you are nurtured and supported. The angels are now guiding you to visualize as they lift you up and carry you to a divine healing temple in the heavens. Visualize that these healing angels are laying you down on a beautiful, sparkling crystal bed of light. As you sink into this beautiful, soft crystal bed, allow the light to permeate every cell of your body and every particle of your consciousness. Notice as this beautiful light begins to cleanse away any tension and any fear, scrubbing you clean until you are crystalline, translucent. Breathing deeply, notice that that beautiful light is beginning to raise your vibration, almost as if there is a small inner volume dial that the angels are gently helping to turn to shift the particles of your being to a slightly higher resonance. Notice as your resonance gently shifts that you start to feel very relaxed. It feels very freeing, as if there is a big part of your mind that is opening, expanding, and unleashing its inner power. Breathe deeply, really allowing yourself to feel comfortable in this beautiful light as it flows throughout you. The angels are showing us that they are now placing their hands over your third eye, and they are channeling emerald green healing light into your third eye, which represents your psychic senses. Feel as this healing light has a gentling effect on your psychic senses, bringing balance and gentleness to all of your faculties of awareness now. Breathe that emerald light throughout the third eye chakra, feeling the emerald light filling up your head and your brain. Feel and allow it to flow down your spine, moving through the throat chakra and going straight for your heart, which is your chakra center for empathy, compassion, and love. Feel the light also filling your heart. Once again, shedding away any energy that you don't need, anything that doesn't suit you, help you to fulfill your purpose, and helping you to feel totally supported, nurtured, and at peace in this moment. Good. The angels are showing us that they are guiding this emerald healing light to create layers and layers of healing energy within and around you. Breathe and bask in this healing energy. And now with your next deep healing breath, we are going to collectively send this healing, calming, nurturing light throughout the earth. So together, let's visualize that we are now sitting up in our lovely little healing crystal beds, and we are using our third eyes to visualize planet Earth right in front of us. Watch and feel as that beautiful emerald healing light spins all around the planet, creating a healing protective glow. Allow that light to touch every single living being in this world, bringing them much needed comfort, peace, reassurance, a sense of safety and healing. Just take another deep breath, holding space for everyone for whom we are sending healing. And if you have any personal intentions of healing, you can think of them now, offer them to the angels and to this healing space now. Good. The angels are now carrying you back to the here and now, helping you to ground right back into your physical body, and asking that you take in one deep, powerful healing breath, feeling as you do so that you are magnetically, powerfully pulling all of your substance right back in through the top of your head of the crown chakra, allowing yourself to float all the way down into the root chakra of your energy system, feeling your energy inhabiting every cell of your physical body, feeling alive, awake, aware, and ready in your fingertips and toes, and just blossoming in your connection with the earth as you deeply enter the here and now. Good. Lastly, we're going to allow the angels to shield you in a veil of bright, purifying white light, keeping you nice and clear, taken care of, and shielded as you go about the rest of your day. The angels are placing that shield around you now, and they're thanking you for holding space today. Take in just one last deep healing breath all together and exhale to open your eyes and shift right back into the room and into the moment. Beautiful. Thank you so much for connecting with me in that. Wow, that felt good, didn't it? Know that when we focus together in uplifting our hearts, our minds, and our energy, that we really can make a big difference. Group prayer and energy work magnifies each of our individual abilities to bring light and healing into this world by quite a lot. So practicing this together really is a service that unites and uplifts us all. All right, so now is the time for us to accept callers. If you have any thoughts or questions about spiritual sensitivity, or if you'd like an angel reading, you can call in now at 240-979-4111. That's 240-979-4111. Great. So it looks like we already have a caller who is ready. All right, let's get connected. Hi, caller. You are on the air. Thank you so much for calling in. If you could just let us know your first name and maybe where you're calling from today.
My name's Mary, and I'm calling from San Diego. And I thank you for the talk. This was wonderful. I loved the meditation. And I have a question about my just the outlook on my finances and relationship right now.
Wonderful. Thank you so much for calling in, Mary. It's great to be connected with you. I'm going to pull a couple of cards, and the cards that I'm working with today are the Angel Tarot cards by Dorian Virtue. I thought these would be perfect for you in asking about both finances and relationships because they're such detailed messages we get from these. So I'm going to turn over our first two cards that I pulled for your finances now. The first card I pulled is the Strength card. This is a card that says that you have great inner strength and that any worries that you have going on right now are totally unnecessary because it looks like everything is going to be totally okay. So let go of any worries or fears. Things are working out really, really well. Your angels want you to know that it looks like you have a lot of inner creativity and inner strength to kind of be a self-starter in terms of how you bring in your abundance. So they're saying know that your creativity, your inner strength, the ideas that you have to work independently as a self-starter, a lot of these things are playing a really beautiful role in bringing in more finances for you in your life right now. So everything will work out. The second card that I pulled is the Knight of Fire. The Knight of Fire is a card that represents actually career and life purpose. Usually our fire cards are all about that. And it represents usually that there might have been a sudden event in your life or maybe intense events going on in your life lately where it feels like there's a lot of that will require a lot of your attention. There's a sense that you need to kind of act, get on top of things, and move some energy around in your life. But they're saying that you have the strength to do this. It feels as if we're at a point right now in terms of what you're doing with your life purpose or career where it's pretty point and shoot. You know what you're meant to do. You have a lot of talent and capability. And it feels like they're saying, don't quit before the miracle or your ship is about to come in. So there's a light at the end of the tunnel. And even if things have been maybe busy or there's been a lot of intensity, things are changing for the better so far. Any questions or thoughts on that before we move on to the relationship stuff?
Well, I think that's wonderful only because I'm getting ready to start a coaching training to become a life coach. And
wow.
That's going to start next month. So I think maybe that lines up with what I'm, you know, meant to do.
Yes, yes. You are a self-starter. That's amazing. It feels as if you having and conducting the business aspects of it as well, whatever efforts you put into that feel like they'll be quite successful. So this is what you should be doing. You're following your calling right now. So go for it. This is your green light from the universe. And I'm just hearing your guides add in your particular help is much needed at this time and that they will be guiding you towards people who need you, or they'll be sending people who need you to you. So anytime you're saying, who's going to be my client or what am I going to do next? Say, God, just bring me who needs me, because there are people that need you for sure already. So that's great. Let's go ahead and turn over. I pulled two cards as well for relationships for you. So I'm going to turn these cards over now, also from Angel Tarot, and see what happens. So our first card is the Chariot card. This is a card that can represent partnerships that might be going through a test of strength, or that you're about to kind of strengthen in a partnership. There's a sense of you're entering into a partnership where there's a lot of strength that feels as if it's significant down to life purpose areas, almost as if, you know, you and your partner would be able to kind of collaborate together, almost feel like a quote unquote power couple sort of thing. They're saying that has a lot to do with the chemistry that leads you into the friendships, partnerships, and romantic relationship things in your life. And it's playing an important role in how these things are growing and changing right now. Have you been experiencing any of that so far?
You know, we haven't so far. Like, I've been with someone for 4 years, but it's been very on and off. And but yet I've felt like he's the right person for me. It's just been really difficult kind of getting things to smooth out because I know I've had a lot of growth to go through. So I'm just thinking that maybe he and I will, it sounds like, move into that role of maybe working together and carrying out our life mission together.
Yeah, even if it's just to the extent I'm hearing that each of you have a strong sense of purpose and are working on each of your things independently and then kind of playing a supporting role for each other, it feels as if life purpose, inner spiritual growth are playing a monumental role in how the two of you are coming together and how the relationship is growing. This card is also telling us that there is going to be some significant change that you might experience going forwards. And what feels to me almost like a shift in how you're recognizing the relationship. This could be a deepening in maybe commitment or some kind of a change in the status that brings a little bit of change. So that's definitely a good thing. Great. So looking down at the next card that we see for your relationship, we have the Knight of Earth. And the Knight of Earth is a card that says that this is a dependable relationship. Loyalty, dedication, trust, commitment, honor, all of these things are very present in this relationship, and they are the things that are to be valued and aimed at going forward in this relationship. This is also a card that can tell us that one or even both of you in your lives are, again, going through some personal changes where you need to really buckle down. You're getting a lot of things done. You're moving through a lot of situational kinds of shifts and things like that. But that has the power to deepen and hone the commitment. And a lot of times your angels are saying that life changes. Things that you're going through will test the metal of a relationship. They'll show you whether or not that relationship is meant to stay or how it's meant to deepen. So I'm just hearing your angels say, notice the ways that life and life's changes, spiritual growth and so forth are maybe playing a role in the way that the two of you are relating with one another and potentially even influencing deepening of commitment, deepening of understanding, or working more closely in a sense of partnership in life. Any thoughts or questions on any of that?
So does it sounds like maybe he looks to be the person that maybe I'm meant to be with, like this particular person is the one and not necessarily a new person coming in. Can you see that?
Right now, this is the person that you're meant to be with. I'm getting a very strong yes on that because they're saying that you need to live out you need to live out this experience. There are lessons that are still in front of you in the relationship that you're in right now. So go for it. The other thing I'm hearing your angels say is this: be very, very in the present moment with regard to how you might think about or decide if this is the one forever sort of thing. They're saying wait and almost test the waters. Again, looking back at that message that they said about watch the way that life's changes, might influence how the commitment either deepens or maybe even doesn't deepen or whatever happens. This is a time for a lot of growing and learning. And going to a place that says, oh, he's definitely the one or whatever, can sometimes get in our way if we're thinking about just being present with the changes themselves or the lessons themselves that are right in front of us. So that's not to say that he's not the one. It's just saying be very present, be open to any of the possibilities, including, yes, maybe we will be partners for life, or maybe I'm meant to do something else, but just be very, very present and aware and keep your standards nice and high because this is your time for forging very new circumstances around this relationship.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah.
You're welcome. You are so welcome, Mary. Thank you so much for calling in.
All right.
All right. Great. So it looks like we have another caller on. Hi, caller. You are on the show. Thank you for calling in. If you could tell us your first name and where you're calling in from today.
Yes. Hi. My name is Xavier, calling from Walnut Creek.
Ah, hi, Xavier. Thank you so much for calling in today. Do you have any specific questions for your angels or about our topic today?
I do. I have questions about how can I really surrender? And I know what that means, and I know that I've done it, and I do it all the time. But I still keep my saying going back to thinking that I have not surrendered completely to God.
Yes. Right away, I'm hearing your angel say the word trust. They're saying really, really learning to trust the world around you is how you will completely allow yourself to kind of do that trust fall, surrender into the universe. And when we surrender, we are able to grow in our connection to source, to the divine, to where we can really feel and communicate with spiritual presence around us or feel the spiritual energy inside of us. Your angels are saying that surrendering is a wonderful thing to focus or to work towards and that they're helping you each step of the way. As we're looking forward, the angels are saying that forgiveness work will actually be really helpful for you in working on trusting, which is, again, is your key to surrendering. They're saying that for so many of us, and they're very grateful for you calling in because I feel like this will apply to a lot of people that are listening as well, when you really work to forgive any person, institution, or situation that you experienced or perceive in your life as having created any kind of past hurt or challenge or difficulty or fear or whatever, when you can forgive it unconditionally, then you can really start to see the world through God's eyes. And you can really start to be in that state of perfect, unconditional trust. And that will be so incredibly healing. The card that I pulled for you today, I pulled the Two of Air card, which represents sometimes when we are a little bit at odds with ourselves. Let's say we're holding on to a little bit of fear in our lives, or mistrust over something that's going on, or maybe even that there's a little part of us that's angry at the world, or sees, you know, conditions that are out in the world, and why does it have to be that way? That's normal. Almost all of us have that. They're saying that forgiveness work is what overcomes any inner discrepancies that we might have, so that we can, you know, really come into a sense of oneness with, you know what, I just unconditionally trust the flow of the divine, the flow of the universe. The second card that I pulled for you is Knight of Water. And Knight of Water is an emotion card saying that emotional healing and emotional balancing is also really, really helpful for your spiritual path. Any other thoughts, questions about any of that?
No, that's very interesting, because it's exactly what I was feeling. So, but the emotional healing, so definitely that's really hit on the spot, the second one. That is something that I need to get healed, emotional.
Yes.
Okay, awesome. Do you see anything about a book?
Yes, let's look at the energy around you. This is interesting. As soon as I tune into a book around you and I look at your energy field, are you feeling guided to write a book? Because it almost feels as if there's a lot of creative energy or messages that can come through you.
I have, and I do, absolutely. Yeah, I see it everywhere, messages to write a book, yes.
Yes, you. I think you have a divine writer inside of you, and a strong mission in this world to bring a lot of light. I see that one of your guides, very strong, is Jesus. You have Jesus around you, and Jesus is a wordsmith. He's a very good communicator. So call in Jesus as you are writing. And yes, absolutely, you are meant to write a book. Your words are meant to bring a lot of healing and light to other people. And one other last little bonus message I'm hearing your angels tell us right now is that perhaps exploring or diving into doing a little bit of past life work might additionally help with any emotional healing or trusting and things like that are going on. They're saying that you're a very old soul. You've experienced and seen a lot on this earth.
Absolutely.
So as you forgive and release stuff from even other lifetimes, that will even greater hone your spiritual abilities and your ability, again, to share your message by writing. So that's wonderful. I just got chills.
Absolutely. I've known that since I was a child. Absolutely, yes. And the funny thing is, I started writing a book about 5 years ago, and I thought I lost my flash drive, you know, the US drive, and I lost it. And I had no idea what happened. Incredible. I just found it about 2 months ago. It just appeared.
Wow. Wow. That's amazing.
Yeah,
that means it's time. Yes. It's time to go back in and start writing again. That's incredible.
Yeah.
That's incredible.
Because I was going through healing. I was going through a lot of healing and pain. And it's amazing where I am right now, where I was 4 years ago. And so now I feel that I'm back in track where I'm supposed to be.
Oh, totally. Your angels are saying that you've learned a lot of deep lessons, and that your mind and heart have been shaped a lot at this time, so that you can deliver the message the best way that you possibly can to help the most amount of people, to open the most amount of minds in the world. So thank you for your work. That's great.
Thank you. Thank you so much. And this was meant to be, because I was not even anything. A friend just texted me a few minutes ago, say, you know, you have two calls, Sarah. And I said, okay. And here I am. So the
Yay.
Angel is guiding me also through you. Absolutely. I have no doubt about that.
Oh, thank you so much.
You know what? Before I go, so interesting. Today that I was driving to work, I usually don't talk to Jesus as I used to. And I said today, Jesus, I'm sorry that I have left you out. I want to get back to you and talk to you. And it's so funny that you mentioned that right now about Jesus.
Wow. He wanted to I think that it was his way of talking right back and saying, yep, I've got your back, buddy. I'm right here. That's
absolutely
so cool.
That it was so interesting you mentioned Jesus. Okay. He's my guide. Okay. Thank you so much. I really appreciate that. And for me, it's a confirmation again that I am the right path.
Yes, you so are. Thank you so much for calling in, Xavier. You got great energy, and I can't wait to see you share your work out there.
Thank you, ma'am. Have a good day.
You too. All right. It looks like we have time for Just one more caller. Oh, it looks like the call might have dropped. Oh, no, they're on. They're back on again. All right. Hi, caller. You are on the air. Could you just go ahead and introduce yourself with your first name and let us know where you're calling from today?
Is that me right here?
Hi.
Hey.
Hi, what's your name and where are you calling from?
From Benicia, California. And my name is Rocco.
Hi, Rocco. Thank you so much for calling in. It's great to connect with you. Do you have any questions or thoughts for the angels today?
Yeah, I wanted some messages from my romance angels and maybe any kind of present advice with my current life's purpose.
Yes, let's do that. Let's pull some cards. I love romance readings. For some reason, they're so exciting to me. So I'm just going to go ahead and pull a couple of cards here from, once again, our Angel Tarot deck. And then I'll pull just two others for life purpose and see what we get today. So The first card that we have for romance is the Ten of Fire. The Ten of Fire says that it feels like your angels want you to really kind of shift your priorities and your focus in your love life. They're showing us that there's a lot of energy, kind of spinning around you quite a bit. And it feels as if in the past you may have had experiences of not quite connecting up in relationships where there is an equality of giving and receiving, or an equality in the way that the two of you might see the world and things like that. So your angels are saying that this is a really good time to kind of shift and create more balance in your outlook, looking to kind of raise your standards and really put your foot down to the universe and state exactly the kinds of things that you want to experience in your love life and your relationship, and to help to creatively hone them and to bring them out. And you have the ability to do that. You have the ability to manifest these things and to heal them in a relationship. The second card that I pulled, let's see, is the Release card. Now, this is a good card because it tells you that you are at the end of a phase or situation in terms of your love life. So when just a moment ago, they showed us that in the past, there were old patterns of maybe imbalances in the relationships and things like that. It looks like we're about to leave that behind for good. And you're about to connect in with relationships that feel more reliable and grounded in all areas of your life beyond just romance and things like that. But in romance, it feels like you're finding someone who is really ready for real commitment, somebody who is so much more emotionally available and situationally available to you than others in the past. And someone also, one of the most important crowning things in this is someone who gives to you so that the balance between giving and receiving is equal. Any questions about that so far?
Well, I mean, maybe to be more direct, is it the person that I'm with, that I'm going back and forth with? It's just like power struggle, and I mean, being really nice about it, but just this person's like so controlling, it's impossible to do anything. You gotta hide if you go to the movies with you, take your little, nephew to the movies or something, she'll get jealous.
Wow. So that is the old pattern that they're talking about. That is the old pattern that it's time to say goodbye to. You have the ability to change that within the relationship should you choose to. If you try to work on that a little bit, see what kind of life lessons that might bring you should you work on it. And or of course, there's always the opportunity to potentially go your own way. Remember, the releasement card usually means that there's an end of something going on in your life. So it's either that, and of course, you've got free will in this. So either you'll choose to maybe walk away and open your arms to something that's a little bit more healthy, a little bit more balanced, again, a little bit more equal in giving and receiving and being able to understand one another with all of that, without any of that toxic energy going on. Or again, as they said, you've got free will, so you can choose to put your best effort forth in trying to do some healing on the relationship until you feel totally fulfilled, as if, you know what, I've done my best in this and now it's time to walk away, or I've done my best in this and now, hallelujah, we've healed it and we're able to continue on together. Definitely, no matter what the outcome is for the specific relationship, it's time to kiss the old pattern of negativity goodbye from the past, if that makes sense. So let's go ahead and just look at life purpose really quickly here as we're kind of moving into the next phase of the relationship, the reading here. So the first card that I pulled is the Three of Water. The Three of Water, according to your angels, represents your dreams in this lifetime, the dreams of what you would like to experience. This is a card that represents a lot of times celebrating life's rites of passages, such as when we get married or when we move to a different part of our career or have children and different things like that. They're saying that being a family person is a big part of your career, and experiencing love and spreading it is a big part of your life purpose. So that's having an influence in the things that are going on for you, life purpose and life's work-wise. The other card that we have right now in this is the Ego card. This is a card that says it's time to clean out and heal anything that might make you a little bit overly focused on negative or fear-based thinking, or even paying attention or doing tasks that you don't like, tasks that are menial, that just don't hearken to your passion and your career. A lot of big changes for you. They're saying it's time to say goodbye to that old pattern too. Your energy would much better be served in this life doing something that makes you feel really, really good. Now, the final card that I pulled for you in terms of life purpose is the Magician card. The Magician card is usually the card that says you're incredibly capable and ready, and you have the resources and abilities to manifest a career or life purpose work in this lifetime that is very, very powerful, that hearkens to what you are passionate about. I do see a lot of creative energy that moves through you, and your angels are saying that you have to engage in that creative energy if you are to feel totally fulfilled and at peace in life. So go for that. Any thoughts on any of the life purpose stuff so far?
Oh yeah, no, it seems right on. Only thing that's confusing is just finding my voice. Like, I've been writing a lot, but I don't think I'm like capable to write a whole book, or at least not that. So I'm just kind of looking for maybe I should just kind of take these things and just have talks and stuff. Or should I just keep doing this? Or should I get somebody to co-author this thing?
Yes. Oh my goodness. This is such a beautiful theme that we have going on today. Yes, you have an inner communicator in you too. As I focus in on your energy body, the angels are pointing to your throat chakra, and they're showing that it's very big, beautiful, and bright. You have a lot of wisdom and a lot of great ideas that you have the ability to express through multiple medium. So it doesn't have to just be writing a whole book all on your own. It can also be writing articles or blogs or speaking in videos or doing all sorts of things, doing talks with people in person. You have a lot of ability to communicate, and the angels are saying to embrace that, to really love yourself and kind of hone and embrace the ability that you have to communicate confidently. With that confidence, you're going to notice that the angels, your guides, the universe around you, is bit by bit starting to increase the kinds of divine assignments that they'll hand to you in life. And you will synchronistically attract all of the right opportunities and spaces to communicate where you're being called to do it. Just as a final little cap on that part of the reading, I pulled the Three of Earth, which is a card that represents the power of creativity. Once again, saying that you're an incredibly creative person, a lot of big, beautiful ideas, and the ability to enable, to empower those ideas, to put them out into the world. This is a card that represents being recognized for having unique and high quality work in your creative pursuits. So definitely go after that kind of stuff. It's time for you to be working on the things that represent your talents, because your talents are needed in this world. So that's really beautiful. Any other questions or thoughts before we wrap up?
Oh, that was great, Sarah. And you're always on point. So, I mean, not you, but who you're channeling, I guess.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Rocco. It was beautiful to connect with you. Such an honor. Thank you so much for calling in. And all right, guys, it looks like we're getting to the end of our show today. Oh my goodness. I could just talk to you guys forever. You're all so wonderful. And it was just, we had some amazing callers in today. I love it when we get these themes going on. We had all three callers, people with these big, beautiful life purposes that were all about communicating their message to the world in varying different ways. I think that that's a sign to all of us who are listening that says you have something to share. Listen to the messages that were given to those callers, because there's probably a message for you in there. So thank you so much, everybody, for listening. Remember that I will be live every third Thursday of the month at 12:30 p.m. Eastern on Project Bring Me to Life, bringing you spiritual discussion and angel messages. And you can tune in every Thursday at this time to hear the rebroadcast of the most recent show. All of my shows are recorded and available to listen to as podcasts on iTunes at Spreaker.com. That's Spreaker.com, and on the app for Android, Stitcher. That's Stitcher. I will be posting the links for the podcast on my Facebook and Twitter pages as soon as it becomes available, in case you missed it. And you can like my Facebook page at facebook.com/SarahHall1111. And you can follow me on Twitter by visiting twitter.com/Seraphim444. That's SERRAPHIM444. And as always, if you'd like to contact me for a reading, spiritual guidance, or healing session, you can visit my website at www.seraphim.com. That's SERRAPHIM.com. And for more fantastic spiritual talk radio, music, art, podcasts, events, and so much more, stay tuned to the Project Bring Me to Life Network and visit www.projectbringmetolife.com. Thanks, guys. Know that I love you so much. And until we meet again, you are so loved and so very blessed. Bye.